Does a potato sink or float? And does it matter what size or shape this potato is? What about the water? Does it matter whether the water is salty like the ocean or whether it's not like a river? My name's Corey and I want to explore whether a potato will sink like a submarine or float like a boat. For this experiment, you will need 2 clear cups or glasses, about half full with water, some salt and a teaspoon, a potato cut into various shapes or sizes by a responsible adult. I have 2 large chunks, 2 small chunks, and 2 thin slices. And finally, you need a tray or a safe place to do the experiment just in case there are any spills. First, I'm going to create my seawater by adding some salt to one of the glasses. Let's pick the right glass. I find that about 3 heaped teaspoons is usually enough. So that's 2. That's 3. Now if you look closely at the water here, you can see that all the salt has fallen to the bottom. But the real ocean doesn't look like this. The real ocean has the salt mixed all through the water. So I'm going to give it a stir. Now it's starting to look really quite cloudy. I think it's stirred in enough. Before we start the experiment, it's important to make a guess about what will happen. I want you to pause the video now and make a prediction about what you think will happen. I think that maybe the big chunks of potato are going to sink in both of them, and maybe these small chunks of potato might float in the salt water and sink in the fresh water. And perhaps these thin slices, maybe they'll float in both. Now it's time to test our potatoes. Let's start with the small chunk. In the river water, it sinks. And in the ocean water, it floats. But what about our big potatoes? They're surely a lot bigger and heavier. In the river water, they sink. Okay, that makes sense. And in the salt water, they float again. Okay, now we're on to our final one, which is our thin slice. In the ocean water, surely this is going to float. And it does. And this is like almost like a boat, so surely it should float in the river water too. But it still sinks. It looks like size and shape didn't matter. All of our potatoes floated in our salt water, and all of our potatoes sank in our fresh water. And the reason for this is called density. Although the potatoes are all different shapes and sizes, they're all the same density. And the fresh water is less dense than the potatoes, so the fresh water floats on top of the potatoes. But the potatoes are less dense than the salt water. And this means that our potatoes float on top of our salt water. Now this is important for cargo ships as well. Like potatoes, cargo ships float well on ocean water where it's nice and salty, and not as well on the fresh water of a river. And this means they can carry a lot more when traveling over the ocean compared to when they're traveling on a river. I wonder if your potato experiments will have the same results as mine. Maybe you could try using different amounts of salt. Or perhaps you can come up with a different potato shape or size to try. You could even explore using sugar instead of salt. Or perhaps a different liquid entirely, like juice or oil. I would love to hear about your own potato experiments. Thanks for watching.